Okay, good evening. My name is Vaughn Spencer. I'm City Council President here in the City of Reading. And this evening on Inside Your City, we're going to have another discussion related to the Caribbean Community Group that's located here in our city, and also talk about a continuation of a topic that we discussed earlier this year, and that had to do with the devastating earthquake that took place in the country of Haiti, and what's happened since then, and some of the things that this community has done to provide aid and assistance, and also to talk to members of the Caribbean Community Group to get some perspective as to what needs to take place today, what needs to be done, and how the community of Reading can help in this tragic tragedy that has occurred on the island. My guest this evening, sitting next to me, is Fabi Nelson, and next to her is Marie Tanis, and the gentleman at the very end is Louis Jean. And of course, throughout this next hour, you're going to be hearing from my guests as to what has occurred and some of the things that we need to still consider, because Fabi, we're being told, listening to the news, that there still are a lot of major issues that are confronting the people on the island, and things that need to take place. Maybe you'd like to start out by talking about some of the things, or any of our guests, some of the things that have occurred since the last time we were on the program.
Well, since the last time we were on, Caribbean Community Group, we're collecting items to send to Haiti. Mm-hmm. And we have collected an overwhelming amount of items. They're currently being held at the Expo Center, I believe. The problem now is getting to send those items to the people of Haiti. Because now a lot of us tend to forget that, you know, this happened, the earthquake happened, then what? Recovery. There's still a lot of rubble there in Haiti. People are living in tents. They're not getting enough water. As you heard in the news, there's a cholera outbreak out there now, mm-hmm. Trying to keep that under control. So Marie might have a little bit more insight on that.
Marie?
Thank you, Council Vaughn, for inviting us tonight. On behalf of Caribbean Community Group, We thank the people of Reading for helping us from the beginning when the earthquake happened. Like Fabi said, we still have our items that we collected over at the Expo Center. Now, we try to do several fundraisers to see if we can raise the money to send those items to Haiti. Unfortunately, we weren't successful enough. We collect only $2,000 and we need $6,000 to send the item to Haiti. We found a donor that donate a trailer so we can pack the item, a big container we can put the item, and we do find a driver that willing to take them to New Jersey for us, but still we need that $4,000 to send to so they can ship them to Haiti for us from New Jersey. We once again come here, we thank you enough for all you do to help us, but we're trying to raise that money. I'm going to introduce to you guys the new pastor of the Bethlehem Seventh Days Adventist Church. We sit in Reading in 501 Chapel Terrace. This is Pastor Louis Jean. He is new in the community. He started doing a lot of work for the small amount of time he's been here. Maybe he has some insight to tell you more about, you know, what he's been doing. Pastor Louis Jean.
Yeah. I want to thank you, the people of Reading, and the council also, to invite me tonight. My name is Pastor Louis Jean Wilfried. And I'm from Michigan, but I have been more for 2 months here. I'm here for the Haitian people in Reading and Allentown. But most of all, I'm here for all the people in Reading area. And our church, Bethlehem Church, is a Haitian community. We speak French and Creole and English also. I would like you to visit my church, and we have been doing a lot of stuff about family. We believe in family. We believe to have a good community, we need to have good family. This is why we are trying to do, and we love young people. We want to help them, and I'm so happy to be here and this community to help also.
Okay, well, thank you. We have a phone number that we'll be showing on the screen where you can call to help provide some assistance to the organization, and whatever monetary help that you can provide would be greatly appreciated, along with any other goods or things that could be supplied. So you'll be seeing that number on the screen. There it is. And again, we appreciate any assistance that you can provide. We know that Hurricane Tomas has been in the news. In fact, we're hearing now that it might not necessarily hit the country, the island of Hispaniola, but more importantly, the country of Haiti. Now they're predicting it'll move kind of to the west or north of it. However, they are predicting a lot of rain. What does that mean to the people in Haiti? Because I think a lot of people aren't familiar with, just again trying to remind folks, the conditions that the people have had to live under since the earthquake.
Well, typically when we would have what you call a tropical storm or something of the sort in Haiti, it's not usually a big problem because Haiti's built for that. Mm-hmm. Brick houses and a lot of shelter for wind and rain and stuff. But since the earthquake happened, a lot of people have been living in tents. I believe over 200,000 people are living in the city alone in tents and cluster. So basically, I don't think it could withstand the wind and the rain. So we need to keep that in mind. And then along with the kids that are going to get sick. I mean, it's just like here. It gets cold, it's raining, and people get the flu, and they get all sorts of things. Not having the means to get medication and vaccinations and things like that, that's going to have a big effect on it.
Well, like you said, they've been saying that it's moving away. You know, I'm keeping my finger crossed because they were showing that little clip on TV how, you know, they're trying to evacuate. When you evacuate them, where are you going to put them? Because, like you know, there's no infrastructure in Haiti. They don't have a shelter. Like here in, you know, where I live, if there is a problem, I know where to go. You know, they would say evacuate, I know where to go. But in Haiti, the government didn't prepare for that. We don't have that. So that's the main concern right now. So they said Red Cross is getting, you know, see if they can evacuate. It's not happening. That's what Fabi said, you know, it's going to cause another problem because when they start raining, water trying to stay on the street or in the canal where there's
mosquitoes
and then, you know, start biting kids and they're going to get sick, there's another problem. All we need, I mean, I don't know what we need to do more. We need to continue helping these people because they're still in need. They're still in need. You know, the earthquake over, what, about 11 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, people still living in a tent.
So there's still rubble.
There's still rubbles on the street. School. Now they're trying to get kids out of school so they can use the tent, like where they go to school, they can use that as shelter. So I think, you know, I know the people in Reading been helping us. Mm-hmm. You know, the Haitian community in Reading, we ask you. I know all of us have family in Haiti. If we can go, you know, if you can call, you can try, you know. There's an election coming up. Here when we said voting is a right, I know some of us who live here cannot vote in Haiti because we're not there constitutionally, we're not allowed to vote, but call a family member, make them vote for the right person.
Okay.
So these, you know, next time if there is an earthquake, if there is an hurricane, so we don't go through that anymore.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And of course some of the issues are because of all the damage that was done because of the earthquake. I mean, you have a lot of infrastructure,
mm-hmm.
Situations that need to be corrected. I think the other concern with the amount of rain, and they were hoping that it wouldn't be a lot of rain, but mm-hmm. I mean, it looks like there's going to be,
mm-hmm.
is a lot of people aren't familiar with the deforestation that has occurred in the country of Haiti, where a lot of the trees
yes.
had been harvested. And so when you get this much rain, you're going to get erosion and mudslides and
exactly.
stuff. So it just seems like it's everything is coming together to create mm-hmm. such a bad situation.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, again, we need to keep in mind that we're talking about a neighbor of ours.
Yes.
A country that, outside of the United States, was another country, the only other country south of us that had become independent, 1804, you know. So there is a lot of connection that needs to take place. And of course, historically, our country was very reluctant to recognize the country of Haiti, because after all, we were having issues of slavery in our country. And anyone that knows the history of the country of Haiti know that it was an uprising of
yes.
slaves against the owners and the countries that were repressing them.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, historically, the United States wasn't too quick to recognize the country, our nearest neighbor. However, we're hoping through the efforts of the Clintons and people like that, that we've refocused now on our neighbor
right.
and that we things that we need to do to help us. I believe we had some pictures of when Mr. Gary Joseph went down to the island.
He recently went down there to in Haiti mm-hmm. so he could see firsthand what was going on, what's happening. And one of the things I remember him saying is when he got there, seeing those kids starving, could you imagine having 2-3 kids and they're standing there under a tent and they can't eat?
Mm-hmm. Maybe somebody might want to talk about the pictures that are going to be displayed here.
This picture is showing it's a family center that we have in Haiti
okay.
That we help feed kids,
oh.
you know, and
okay.
their parents also. And this is like a group of women with the children that come in. This is our banner right there, a million hands together serving million in need, which is we can go. And this is the food we've been distributing to the kids and their parents when they come to the center. And all of this is part of Caribbean community group that we provide to this a group of people in that area. It's in the south of Haiti. And you know, believe it or not, they help a lot of family. It does help a lot of family. This is like rice and beans, you know, our main dish that we Haitian eat a lot. And
it seems like everybody got a rice
and beans.
Rice and beans. You know, down south here, you know, they called them Hoppin' Johns, black-eyed peas and rice. You know.
Yeah, this is what we eat. Yeah. Yeah, this is the children at the table, ready to eat. Yeah, this is them at the center. They're ready to be served.
And the center's main focus is the children, because they are yeah. supposed to be our future.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if we can feed them, what is our future?
If you're looking in the middle, there's Gary right there taking pride in the picture. You know. So this is one of the, you know, this is like probably a small thing. You know, probably you spend like $15-$20 to do this.
Oh yeah?
You know, to feed like a whole group of people, you know. And you know, here you go to the grocery store, you buy like 3-4 items and you're like $50,
mm-hmm.
you know. But in Haiti, like you send like $20 after they exchange it to the Haitian money, you know, it can feed a whole lot of neighborhood, you know.
So for a lot of the people here in our community,
mm-hmm.
it might mean giving up a couple of sodas.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
a soda a week
mm-hmm.
for a month or
yeah.
Some Starbucks coffee, you know.
Yes.
Sacrifice yes. a little bit of that
a
and
little
they
bit,
can
you know?
Really make an impact on somebody's life.
Actually, if you give $20 for one kid,
mm-hmm.
that can feed the kid for a month.
Yeah.
Wow.
And
uh-huh.
even send them
$20
to school.
$20
will
feed a child for a month.
And, yes, and can also send them to school.
And look at all the good things they're trying to do.
Look,
planting trees.
They're planting trees. They're learning mm-hmm. how to, like, you know, plant trees in the area. So, you know, as they grow, the tree grow. And those people, everybody who's serving the food, they all, like, volunteer. You know,
okay.
they don't get paid nothing. They just volunteer, and we send the money down to them, and then they volunteer to keep you know, cook the food, get the food ready, and then the kids come over, and then they do that, and they help them with, you know, we need to do that because all, you know, we're getting old.
And then we are?
Yeah, I am. I know I am, you know. But it's you know, if we're getting old, and we need the generation behind us to be, you know, ready to serve the country. So that's the help we need. If like you said, if somebody, you know, if you buy a cup of coffee, like $4 or $5, you know, that can feed like one child for like probably a week or so. So that would be good.
The point to those pictures is that's only a small group. That's not even 1% of the amount of kids we need to feed.
Right.
So yes, it is good what we're doing, but we need more help.
Okay.
We definitely need to provide more.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, we have the next thing we have planned. It's a meeting coming up on November 20th. We invited the whole community at Reading. It's going to be on 13th Street. At the Lutheran Nativity Church next to Albright College. Mm-hmm. We're gonna have a meeting. We're gonna discuss all our issues. You know, if you wanna be part of Caribbean Community Group, how to register to be part of it. So that meeting will be important. We ask everybody to come. It's gonna be at 7 o'clock on the 20th at the Lutheran Nativity Church and 13th Street, North 13th Street.
Yeah, that's at 13th and Amity.
Yes.
Right on the
yes.
corner there. Mm-hmm. Let me ask you this question, because we saw pictures of a lot of the children and stuff. What's happening with school? Fabi, I heard you mention something about schools are still, a lot of them are still being held in the tents. School supplies, I mean, are these something that also is a need for?
It's so much, yes. My niece, for example, she's been living here since the earthquake, and now she has to go back to school, and it's a ridiculous amount of money just to register your child in school that I couldn't afford it. Mm-hmm. And I have a job, I work. Could you imagine someone who doesn't have a job? So what's going to happen to that child?
Right.
That child is not going to go to school, not going to get an education, and then that's how the whole community goes down. Mm-hmm. So yes, if anybody could donate school supplies, books, pens, whatever it is, we'll be grateful.
You know, another idea might be, it might be some consideration of adopting a child, schooling. Since you're saying that is expensive, I mean that would be a great way of providing some assistance, and something that could benefit greatly the future of the country. Yeah.
Exactly.
Because $20 is not a lot of money for us here, and if you adopt a child for $20 a month. That will send the child to school, pay the school, and feed the child,
mm-hmm.
and get a better future for the child and for the country also.
Mm-hmm. That's a good point. That's a good point.
We got a program also is coming on December 4th. I, like Sister, I need to talk about that program from the church and the community also.
Okay, Pastor, since the pastor been here, he been running this seminar on family. On every Friday or every Saturday night, he'll be running it. It's really interesting, you know. And you need to get together with your family. Sometimes, you know, moms go to work, dads go to work, you know. They came from school. They're not kids, you know, nobody's home. They're growing up. Some, you know, parents need to stick together to, you know, find a way to raise your child.
Mm-hmm.
Today I was watching on the Today Show. They were showing how to eat dinner with your family, not the food. You know, your kids talk more to you when that happens.
Right.
You find out what going underlies more. So on December 4th, pastor here wants to meet church members, anybody in the community who's been married. It doesn't matter how long you've been married. You would like to renew your vows. Pastor want to do that. And the other thing he wants to do also, if there is somebody in the community who needs to get married financially, is not able to do it, he wants you to get in contact with them. He will, you know, talk to you and then, you know, get the thing legalized and so he can, you know, do it for you. On December 24th, we'll have a big, we're going to say it's a big banquet, a big gala, where we'll have, he will show the last part of the seminar. will be showing, will be discussed on that day. And then that's the day we'll have that big gala, and then everybody will be married in the church or outside of the church who would willing to come in, and then renew your vow and pass your vows, and the pastor will come. We'll do that for you. And to get more information, you need to call. You can call Pastor at
269-277-1506.
And then that number, you can get more information on, you know, what you need to do, how we're going to do this. We're still looking for a place. I don't have exact place yet where it's going to be happening, because we want to have a reception afterward. Mm-hmm. So we're still looking for a hall to do it. And once we get the information, we'll be, you know, pass it on to the community.
Okay. We want to invite everybody in the community. Mm-hmm. You don't need to be a Seventh-day Adventist. You don't need to be a Haitian. You just want to invite everybody to come to take part of this
chance for
event.
The community to come together and yes. And be able on and celebrate the renewal of vows yeah. and stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a good idea. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just wanted to add, even the youth, you should come to the seminar also. I've been at the church. It's really good to teach you how to get along with each other, and if you have a boyfriend or if you have a girlfriend, and a lot of the times we don't understand each other, that seminar is really good to avoid complication in the future. I wish I attended earlier and I learned a valuable lesson.
Well, it's good to know that something like that is being held, because, as you know, there's been a tremendous effort within our community to get families to reconnect. Some of the stuff going on with some of the youth here in Reading, building stronger family ties. Any assistance that we can get, and it's usually from our religious community that's really stepping forward helping our city with those issues. So, yeah, we'll make sure that we provide that information for everyone. Real quick, any family-related stories? Anybody with family on the island? And could you share something about how the family's doing?
Well, I have family in the island. Mm-hmm. I talk to them, you know, almost every day. My father also talks to everybody every day, give me updates. They doing, you know, they're trying to recope, you know, try to go back on to their normal lives. I know my sister has moved. She was afraid to go inside up to live in the house because she was afraid something else might happen. But now, you know, after she, you know, she went back to live in her house. My family are from the south, where it was hate the most. Everything is trying to go back. My dad visited, and you know, he went back pictures. He shows that, you know, everybody tried to get on, move on with their life, but it's not easy. Mm-hmm. It's not easy because, as you know, after the quake, there was a lot of the jailhouse broke, and then, you know, there was a lot of bandit on the street. You know, they were trying to, you know, they were raping, killing, they were doing everything. So it's not secure 100%, but people try to get back, you know, to their normal lives.
Well, I just want to remind everyone again, if we could have on the screen again the number of the Caribbean Community Group. We're asking for some more assistance from our community to help the families in Haiti. Think about adopting a child for $20 a month. They're also in need of some financial resources to be able to get some of the goods that the community has, that the Caribbean Community Group has been able to collect. We need to get that to a location, in New Jersey?
Yes.
So that it can get to the island. But any help that you can provide would be greatly appreciated. And the number's on the screen, 610-207. I don't have my glasses on.
2671.
But you need to contact that number. And, you know, once again, because I see we're running short on time, but once again, I would like to thank my guests who are here. And would anybody like to have the last word?
I would like to invite all the community to come to visit my church, Bethlehem Church, and to come to be a part also in that program we're going to have on December 4th. God bless you.
Okay.
We thank everyone again for donating, for continuing to help Caribbean Community Group and the people of Haiti. Like I said, we still need your help, monetary, to send the stuff to Haiti. So please help. You can call the number that was on the screen, which is 610-207-2671. Thank you.
I just wanted to say thank you for having us once again on the show and being able to express how we're feeling and asking for help. Anything you could do, even if you could come and help put the stuff on the trailer, that will help also.
Okay, so we need some manpower.
Manpower, everything.
All right, well, I would like to thank Fabi, Marie, Louis-Jean for being here with me. And again, if you can help, please do so, and good night.